Your parents didn't want a vagrant's life for you, lad. They wanted to grow to be a man of learning and influence, a man of worth.
Family this season really is, I think, a strong motivation for Jamie and Claire. He's always wanted to have an extended family and a home. And finally, he has this opportunity, and he has actually everyone around him that he loves.
Creating family is a huge part of this season, and it's a theme of the books, that family is who we make it. Young Ian is really like a son to Jamie. Fergus, his other son that he adopted in Paris, more or less, and to have him and his new wife and their baby, this family's growing.
You make a fine father.
Thank you, my lord.
When my body dies, my soul will still be yours.
Jamie and Claire's relationship is probably the most solid and settled that we've ever seen before. We never doubted their love, but there was whether or not they could survive this separation that was constantly happening. But now it's a chance to explore a mature relationship.
They're at peace with each other, I think. You know, they're a great team. It's nice to see them have this domestic bliss, and think, you know, fans really enjoy those moments of seeing Jamie and Claire, you know, without words, knowing what the other one needs or how they interact in a domestic environment.
As soon as our guests leave, I'll be expecting your full attention.
It was a really interesting story to tell, of the two of them coming together, you know, as a mature couple, which is not typically something that you see on television. It was fun to do, because it keeps challenging and sort of stretching the boundaries of what you think the show is.
It's also a very different side of Claire. I think prior seasons, you know, last season especially, we focused so much on her development as a professional career woman and as a mother. And this season was definitely her focusing on a much more nurturing side of herself.
Katrina Balfe is a very good actress. She can't stand me. She pretends to enjoy my company, but she's wonderful, you know, and not only a wonderful actress and very talented, but she's become a very good friend. And I think that personal relationship we have is on screen, and I think that's something that we bring to it.
Well, what's this?
It's a small scene, but one of my favorites, between Jamie and Clarice when he gives her the medical chest as, you know, an anniversary gift.
Do you like it?
This is a sign that he recognizes what she is and what's important to her.
It's a really beautiful thing to see the inner mechanics of this relationship work.
Do you trust me, Claire?
With my life.
I think Jamie and Claire have one of those relationships whereby they tell each other everything and they communicate, and, you know, no matter how awful the news might be, they're very honest with each other. Roger and Bree are so bad at communicating. The scene where Brianna and Roger meet at the airport, and, you know, if that was Jamie and Claire, it would be some wonderful epic reunion and it would be beautiful and romantic. And we were like, you know what, let's Brianna and Roger this. Let's make it a little bit, oh, we don't know where we stand.
Hi.
Just yeah. Say something, or just kiss her, or just tell her you love her, for God's sake.
And it's very real in that way. Shall we?
Maybe just a wee drum.
We wanted to show that there was a sense of them being on different pages, that Roger had one thing in mind and Brianna had something else in mind.
Brianna and Roger are in that throes of early passion. The passion goes both ways, in good and bad.
Roger almost immediately falls in love with Bree, just like Jamie does with Claire.
I want to have a home with you. I want to have a home big enough for four or five wee Mackenzies. A couple of dogs.
Roger, stop. I'm not ready for this.
Because of her past relationship with her parents and what happened to Claire and Frank, I think she's very nervous and she can't let her guard down.